Good evening, everybody. Back with another simple meal preparation. Remember that breakfast where we had the spicy chorizo sausage? Well, with the eggs and, you know, the toast. Well, I'm going to, as promised, make a hoagie out of that leftover chorizo. So I've got my ingredients here. Let's take a look. If we can do this without causing too much of a ruckus. Here's the chorizo. We've got our hoagie roll, which we will cut in half. I think we should grill this to make it kind of a golden brown, right? And I cut up a little bit of avocado over here to put on the chorizo. Can you see that? I don't think you can quite see it. Let's move this over just a little bit. Okay, there it is. What we'll also do, we'll slice up a little bit of cheese to put on it. That's double wrapped for freshness, right? I don't know what kind of cheese this even is, but whatever kind it is, we're going to have a little bit. So we'll, again, do this without cutting my fingers off. We'll do that, like that. I think I cut too much off there, but that's okay. We'll find another use for it, like snacking, or putting it on our chips to make, what do you call that when you put cheese on chips? Now I'm forgetting my vocabulary. Well, let's cut this up a little bit. Just cut some little pieces of cheese here. Go with our guacamole. And I think I'll eat this little piece as a snack while I'm talking to you. All right. What we'll also do, take some of this chorizo sausage and kind of cut that up so that we can toss it into the pan and saute it just a little bit for our sandwich after we grill the bread. That should be about enough. Okay, so let's go ahead and take care of the grilling operation now. All right, our pan is heating up. We buttered up our two hoagie halves here. We'll put them in there. They're not sizzling, so I think my fire, I don't think I was quite heated up enough, but there we go. Now I'm hearing a little bit of sizzle right there. Okay. We were close, just not quite there yet. So we'll let those be a nice golden brown. Maybe I can burn my fingers while I'm at it. Do you think? Most cooks end up burning themselves now and then. In which case, you gotta put ice on the burn immediately, and then it will keep from being a bad burn. I know that sounds hokey, but it's not. It's actually true. So, let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to pause for a moment right here. All right, so we're still grilling our bread. Let's cheat just for a second and take a peek. Yeah, it's starting to brown. This one's pretty good. It's almost there. I like it pretty crispy myself. I don't know how you like grilled sandwiches, hoagies, but on a French roll. But myself, I like it pretty brown. So, you know, women, hoagie rolls, whatever. A little bit more brown and, you know, your food a little spicy, okay? Not too bland. Turn that down just a little bit, and there goes the AC kicking on cue. Alright, so I think these are done because they're starting to smoke just a little bit. Yep, perfect. Nice, golden, toasty a little bit. Alright, now I'm going to put a little bit of butter in here to saute up. So, I'm going to shove in our sausage here, like that, and just kind of let that heat up and saute up in that little bit of butter there. Makes a nice sound, sort of like a campfire. Hmm? Turn them over once one side gets a little bit done. They're browning up pretty quick, and it's already cooked, fully cooked. There. We got all of them flipped over. So let that little saute just a little bit longer. That pan. A clever chef who knows what he's doing would try to melt the cheese on these guys right here. I don't know if I'm that brave. I usually just stick it in the microwave afterwards, but let's give it a shot this time, right? See if we can pull this off just this once. The cheese melt right onto the chorizo. Putting it in the microwave is kind of a cheat, isn't it? But we don't want to cheat if we can avoid it. I still don't know what kind of cheese that is. I also think we need a culprit for this.
Let's see if we can find one.
We put this over there like that. That's going to make the cheese melt on really nice. And it's also going to make sure that chorizo is fully heated. So we'll just leave that on a few seconds. And I'm kind of an impatient cook, you know? Yeah, it's melting on there now. Another 20 or 30 seconds and we'll have it made. Be able to put that right onto our bottom piece here. I'll turn off the burner right now so I don't forget. And it will continue to cook and heat up in there properly while we're waiting. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. So now we'll just scoop this onto our bottom piece of bread. Well, that looks pretty yummy to me. I don't know what you think, but I think that looks pretty yummy. And we will put our avocado on there. A little bit of avocado. To add a little bit of a, you know, southwestern flavor. Omega-3s. You can pay a lot for this in a restaurant. I think you would pay quite a bit. I think all that needs just a little bit of mustard, don't you? Let's take it over here to the other counter. Let's go back over here and finish our dinner preparation. First, we'll put a little bit of mustard on there. This mustard's almost gone, as you can hear, but I have a backup tube. Sorry, folks, that's very rude. Next time I'll use Beano first. Now, what was I gonna do? I don't remember. Oh, I was gonna find my knife, that's it. Let's get our knife, cut this into halves. Case I can't eat the whole thing at once. Now, doesn't that look pretty and appetizing? It looks very yummy to me, okay? Next, of course, I have an apple here that I just washed. Okay, I always wash my fruit, of course. And I don't know if I want to eat the whole apple. Wow, this one's hard to cut. They're usually not so tough. But I want to eat some segments of it. So once again, I'll be lazy. And a little bit wasteful. But I gotta get some fruit in, right? So we're gonna cut some of that apple right there. A few more wedges, I think, will work. Don't worry, I won't waste the rest. That's enough segments. If I have too much apple, then it's, I don't know, bad for my digestion. Okay, so the apple. And I think we need a few Tostitos, since it's kind of a Western theme dinner. Let's have a few Tostitos. Go with that. There we go. Now we have, just like breakfast, we have a very nice comfort food dinner, complete with fruit and everything. I'm going to take that over to the table along with my water, and we'll check it out and see if it's good. All right, so there we go. We got the yummy looking chorizo, avocado, some cheese and mustard, and we got our apple slices so we can pretend to be eating healthy, and we have some nice salty Tostito chips. Now let's check this out and see if it's any good. That is really good. I think I'm going to open a chorizo lunch stand for hoagies. You can have pastrami and roast beef. Sorry, folks. It's so good I can't speak. Let's have a chip for some crunch. Doesn't that look very nice with the corn? I must confess, There it goes again. Sorry to keep whining about the difficult... Sometimes shooting ASMR is not pretty, folks. I don't want you to try this at home because you might have a million distractions and noises. Anyway, as I was saying, yummy, yummy. We haven't had an apple yet. Let's try it. Just the right amount of tart versus sweet. That's a good Granny Smith apple. What shall we have for dessert? I have some Rocky Road ice cream in the fridge, in the freezer, that I'm not supposed to eat. If I have a little bowl, don't tell anybody. I won't say anything if you don't. I think Rocky Road is my favorite, other than maybe Ben and Jerry's Fudge Brownie or whatever it's called. I like chocolate. I didn't do a glass this time. Oh, it's spilling all over me. At least it's not something that will stain. Besides, it's really hot here. So if water spills on me, that's okay. In a previous video, you guys were laughing at me because I went and splashed water on my face and forgot to take my glasses off first. I think I used a spray bottle. That's so good. I also still have a little bit of another one of these hard lemonade watermelon things. Since my name is Mikey, it's appropriate I buy this brand, right? Still got some carbonation in it. Pretty good. We'll have another little apple wedge, and then I will eat the rest of my dinner in peace, even though I love having you all here. I'm kind of a loner when I eat. I like to read. I'm one of those guys who always has to have something to read when I'm eating. They never understood me at work because they would always try to get me to go to lunch and be social. And I just wanted to eat my lunch in peace and read my magazine or paper or the internet or whatever, because I was interacting with people all day long. In my career professional function, I was in a difficult aerospace rocket science engineering management position, and all day it was meetings and dealing with problems and engineers that reported to me and so forth and so on. At lunchtime, I needed a break from all that. I think some folks thought I was antisocial, and it's not that, it's just that I needed some quiet time, you know, to get my head together. And eating and reading the paper. Well, that stopped when no one was delivering the paper anymore, but, you know, reading the internet or whatever magazine. Thirsty now. This chorizo is a little bit salty and quite spicy. Sometimes I can drink a whole bottle at once, but I can't do that with a beer, okay? So don't ask. I mean, I could, but nowadays I'd probably burp or something, fall asleep, you know? I'm almost half done. But once again, I'm already full. So, I think one more little apple wedge, and then I'll be signing off. I should do a blooper video of all the sounds that interrupt my ASMR here and cause me to do 8 takes of one video, right? On the Omaha instruction video, that's how it was. I finally kind of gave up. But when I have my own place, which I have in Oregon, I'll be moving there in not too long. I have reasons I need to stay down here for now. You know, I gotta go have cataract surgery in a few weeks at Kaiser, which is my medical plan here. They don't have it on the Oregon coast, so I wanna have perfect vision before I retire. And, you know, anyway, they're very mild, you know, I can see really well. It's only at night, the bright lights and stuff that bug me right now. But anyway, I'm gonna go because I'm done eating. I'm gonna save this other half of this lovely chorizo sandwich for a snack after my long walk, and then I'll have appetite again. So until next time, don't ASMR and drive, guys.